So we're so delighted to have you, Mr. Venkatesh and Mr. Ravi over here. You've been the jury members of Entrepreneur India Awards. So since you so kindly helped us with selection of the right candidates, what is your opinion about the startup ecosystem? Particularly, let's start with you, Mr. Venkatesh. If you can tell us what do you think, how it is evolving, and particularly, with IIM Bangalore and young children graduating out of there. What is it that you feel is their overall mental makeup in terms of embracing entrepreneurship and doing a startup?
Okay, thank you. I think from our side, there's two sets of people who are trying entrepreneurship. One is from the student community, and I think that is not robust right now, and for various reasons. As you know, Indian students go through literally a kitchen sink, and it's very difficult for them to get seriously into entrepreneurship. Of course, there's always going to be a small percentage of students who always try this out. But I think the larger pool of entrepreneurs coming into the ecosystem is from people who have been, let's say, 5 years, somewhere between 5 and 10 years of work experience. And I think they are the ones who are reasonably financially secure.
Sure.
And at the same time, they sort of taken care of the family, and they don't have the immediate need to sustain their families. And at the same time, they have seen the work environment and they can see what they can do. They sort of got the firsthand experience of, figuring out how they can contribute in a big way.
Right.
And if you put on top of it all these cover stories of Zomatos and Ola, I mean, Uber and Ola and all those entrepreneurs coming out, I think then it's a fascinating area right now for people to try out. And what we do in IIM Bangalore is give them the safe place to
Right.
try their first venture. Even if it fails, we focus on the entrepreneur. So I'm actually very proud to say that after 3 years of graduation from IIM Bangalore, more than 75% of entrepreneurs stay in the journey. I mean, they don't quit, which I think is, I think that's the
That's the
main mission for us.
Yes, absolutely. I agree. And I feel that, it's something that even if they don't gorge on it in the first few years where they might want to sort of get some market experience, be a professional, and then they might jump into the entrepreneurship bandwagon, which is actually good because, that they would be making less mistakes and be far more confident in their venture. Mr. Ravi, what is your opinion about how do you feel the startup ecosystem is evolving? Where do you think young entrepreneur or young people in India, they are, how are they embracing entrepreneurship today?
So my take is that there are these young entrepreneurs who have bright ideas, and most importantly, these bright ideas must be converted into business ventures, and that is the key. And if they have the right sort of mentors and the right type of capital that they are backed up with, it can work wonders. Now, let me give you an example. When I was chairman of Bombay Stock Exchange, we had an incubator. And we had another incubator in Varanasi too. So where these youngsters came up with very good ideas, and some of the very experienced people actually helped them in converting ideas into reality. And
Sure.
then, because what happens, it's not only about ideas, it is how to transform those ideas into business models.
Correct.
And that is the key to the whole thing. And the cash burns are very high to start with.
Right.
And can they sustain the cash burns? And they should not get derailed at any stage, at any point of time. So handholding, getting the right mentors, getting the right capital. And I, in the whole jury sheet, I could see lot of them were backed by very, very good PE funds, etc., venture capitals, etc., and good amount of backing with a good idea and with a very, very strong line of thinking that they have to achieve it, and also being flexible in changing the business model based on the environment is the key for any entrepreneur to succeed. And it's a great ecosystem. And I think the pandemic has shown that all of them have done well, especially in the fintech part of it. It's been a brilliant show. Cash deliveries at home, small loans for people. All this has happened. That's because we had the right ideas.
Absolutely. And I think technology has completely changed the entire ecosystem. And, you know, consumers, young or senior, they're all changing. And I think they're all adapting to the new ways of technology is thrown at us. And I don't think we'll be able to go back to the same world, you know, wherein we were doing transactions through on paper and going to the banks. So I think that is certainly bound to change. Any thoughts you have on the, on the companies that you, on the startups, whom as jury you found, or some highlights you found during the awards, which you might want to share with the award winners today?
So I must confess that the range of entries that came was very different, right from nutrition, health, then you have fintech, you had logistics, you had all sort of entries, games, means, and gaming was one. So it was also e-commerce. So it was multiple entries, and the quality of entries and the quality of all of them was very good. And I must tell you, confess, I was finding it very difficult to distinguish between some of them. And I of course did not use a lottery system. I went more than that, just tried to Google more about them, apart from the data that you gave, how to distinguish between very close competition. And I know each one deserves it. And it's very difficult to put a joint winner or whatever, that is the process. But what I was very amazed is the type of competition, the type of ideas that came in, nutrition, logistics, agri, and everything. And everything was there. It was a full package. And I could see that, most of them will do well as they move forward if they have the right guidance. But it was a wonderful experience. I used the whole of Saturday and Sunday doing this exercise. I must tell you very frankly. And I was struggling to select the right ones because they were too close, they were very competitive.
Sure. No, thank you for, being the jury for Entrepreneur India Awards and actually taking the time to select the right winners. Mr. Venkatesh, any thoughts you have as jury member that you want to share, or anything that came to you?
Yeah, actually, I totally concur with Mr. Ravi that, it's a shame that we have to select one. I think there are too many good candidates in the pool. What I found interesting is that some of them, on a broad innovation point of view, a lot of them were very similar, but I gave a little bit more weight to those who were also building the system around them. Like, right. For example, there was an agri startup, which was actually helping train the youth to help them. So even though it is in their enlightened self-interest, they're trying to increase their business access, but really what they're trying to do is to carry the society with them, which I thought is something that we as a country desperately need, right. Just not focus only on your thing, but also bring other stakeholders up as well. So I thought that was very interesting. And similarly, I was, for example, I also had the real estate initiative, and one of the areas that I was very keen to focus on was the real estate startup. And I think what happened is that there are these real estate players, which are the traditional conventional players. And then there are people who are completely turning the industry upside down, the way they think about the future of real estate itself, whether should you even have offices. In fact, the company that I actually voted highly was a company which is actually reinventing the working space itself.
Right.
And I think this sort of an idea, which is more futuristic and not on the current plane, is very fascinating, because I think we soon are going to reach that stage where, as we see the uberization of the economy is happening in front of us, and it's going to happen even more with COVID as far as the office space is concerned. So I think I voted more for people like that, who are helping the society build those gaps, I mean, plug those gaps in the society, and people who are turning the industry on their heels.
Sure. Thank you very much. And I think basis on the votes and the points that you gave to each of the startup, each of the nominee, we did a pool of all the six jury members in terms of how they voted. And basis that, the final winner has been selected, which we want to sort of showcase now in front of you. And if you could also sort of appreciate and congratulate the winners with us and honor them with the Entrepreneur Award. So may I ask Puneet if she can please announce the award winners?
Sure. Thank you so much, Ms. Maria, for that. We're just going to be now commencing towards the awards. We've got a lot of excitement. Ms. Maria, I have to say that the session was so brilliant from the very start of the day. And right now we're on our final set of awards. So let's do that. And firstly, thank you so much to our eminent panelists also for joining us, our jury in this session, particularly for joining us and being a part of our great day. So ladies and gentlemen, as given with the cue, let's start with the presets of our awards. First up, let's head to the Emerging Startup of the Year. Could we have the preset now being displayed? So in the humble presence of our jury, we're just going to be starting with the awards. So I believe there could be a slight delay, Ms. Maria. We just meanwhile request the team. You know, we've waited so patiently for, you know, this set of awards as well. And we'll just be requesting the team. But meanwhile, to our eminent jury, first up, Mr. Ravi, I've always had the humble honor of, you know, we did interact in the previous one of our events. Just as our jury, just your words of encouragement, sir. And of course, we'll go to Venkatesh ji as well. So your words of encouragement to our, you know, all the ones who've put in their entries and, you know, who are going to be winning. So over to you.
So first, any award is a very inspiring thing, and it's a sense of satisfaction that one gets when we get an award. But it also means those who have not got it, that there is a bit of scope for them to improve and get the award the next year. So awards are this temporary or permanent happiness, whichever way you can put it, but that is the spirit. Award is just a way of just recognizing the work that we have done in a chosen field. So, and the best part is in this award that I witnessed, that we did not interact with any jury, other jury. So we were all independent. So there was no thought process that went into influencing others. And that's why today, when we come out with winners, it's an opinion that has been built with various ideas. For example, Mr. Venkatesh just mentioned about what he thinks, what they can bring to the society. I was looking at it, how will they scale up? Can this business scale up to certain levels? Will it sustain the long run? So so everybody has a different perspective to this. And that is why I feel that a combination of people and a combination of factors, and when we select the person who's the winner, it's a multi-dimensional sort of a approach that we have had. And that's, I think that's the most interesting part of this award. And I think the winner should feel very happy. It means, and it's a very, very, it gives us hope for the future. It also encourages to move forward. And also for those who have just not made it, it gives them go back to the drawing board and see what all they can do to improve themselves. So that, and also, it also brings a competitive spirit, which is very important amongst all the competition that is, and there is a huge level of competition in some segments, and I think that is the primary aspect.
Right. Thank you so much for those words of encouragement. I'd also like to go to our jury, Venkatesh, if I may call you Venki, sir. Sure. Just your words of encouragement to all those who participated, and as importantly, you know, our jury, Raviji, said that it's also about the competition which is created, but you know, how much efforts they've put in. So we'd just like to hear from you as well.
Yeah, this is what I tell my startups at IMB, that, you know, really the best award is from the customers. So really, you know, winning several such awards like these, even though it is good to put in your resume or put in thing, but really what matters at the end of the day for them is the customer validation. So I would strongly want to tell all the startups here that, you know, their focus should only be on that. You know, because it's very tempting for people to get, you know, to apply for various awards here and there, recognitions here and there. But in the startup world, those things don't really matter. It's not like students, you know, wanting to win some prizes here and there. So I really think the focus should be on the customer. They should understand their customer. And at the end of the day, if the customer validates it by putting their money on their product, then nothing like it. So then they have won the best award.